Hello and welcome to Edusathi's lecture on trigonometry. This is a relatively easy topic, but you need to know a few concepts before you start solving questions. So let's begin. What is trigonometry? The study of relationship between the sides and angles of a triangle. Mostly we'll be dealing here with only right angled triangle. So a right angled triangle is a triangle which has one angle equal to 90 degrees. So it's a triangle like this. So this angle is 90 degree, and if I take this angle as theta, then this opposite angle becomes 180, which is the sum of the angles of a triangle, minus 90 this angle minus this angle theta. So this becomes 90 minus theta. So broadly we'll be discussing trigonometric ratios, trigonometric identities, values of some specific angles, the angle measure formula, trigonometric functions, trigonometric values of higher angles, trigonometric equations, and then finally heights and distances. This is basically application of trigonometry in real life, and this is where most of the questions are asked. So let's begin. So the first thing we do is, what are trigonometric ratios? We first discuss the Pythagoras formula. I'm sure that most of you know what is a Pythagoras formula. So if we have a right angle triangle, so this angle is 90 degrees, this angle is theta, so this angle automatically becomes 90 minus theta. The two sides which contain the 90 degree angle are called the perpendicular and the base. I can name this as the base and this as the perpendicular. It does not make a difference. The only thing you need to keep in mind is that the two sides which form this 90 degree angle are the perpendicular and base, and the side opposite to this 90 degree angle is called the hypotenuse. We denote it by H. The Pythagorean's theorem says that perpendicular square plus base square is equal to the hypotenuse square. So this is the Pythagoras theorem in short. Now let's discuss the trigonometric ratios. The first ratio we discuss is sine theta. Sine theta is defined as the sine of this angle A here. This is equal to perpendicular, that is the side which is opposite to this angle, which is P in this case, divided by the hypotenuse, which is H. Similarly, cos theta is defined as base, that is the side which is adjacent to this angle theta. Base is adjacent to this angle theta, divided by the hypotenuse, again, which is H. Then we have tan theta. Tan theta is defined as perpendicular by this base. So perpendicular is the side which is opposite to theta. This is the convention we generally use, divided by the base which is adjacent to theta. So we have P by B. Also, tan theta can be written as sin theta divided by cos theta. Now if you solve this, what is sin theta? I have P by H. So I have P by H. And what is cos theta? It is b by h. So I have divided by b by h. So this h and this h cancels out. So I have p by b, which is tan theta. Now the next ratio is cosecant theta. Cosecant theta is nothing but 1 divided by sine theta. So you just take the reciprocal of this ratio and you have cosecant theta. Similarly, secant theta, this is the reciprocal of cos theta. So this ratio here, you take its reciprocal and you have secant theta. And cot theta is the reciprocal of tan theta. So what you need to do again is take this P by B, take its reciprocal, you have B by P, and this is what is cot theta. So 1 by tan theta. Also, the cot theta can be written as cosecant theta by secant theta. Or it can also be written as, what is cosecant theta? 1 by sine theta. So I can write this as 1 by sine theta divided by, secant theta is 1 by cos theta. So 1 by cos theta, and this becomes equal to cos theta divided by sine theta. So here also it proves I had tan theta as sine theta divided by cos theta. And here the cot theta, I have cos theta divided by sine theta. So it's the reciprocal for tan theta. Now, if out of the 6 trigonometric ratios which we've discussed, any one of the ratios is known, the remaining ratios can also be obtained. For example, it's given in the question, let's say sine theta is equal to 5 by 13. So what I know here is that since this is theta, sine theta is what? Perpendicular by the hypotenuse. So perpendicular here is this one, which is 5k, and the hypotenuse is written as 13k. Now I cannot write if sine theta is 5 by 13. So I cannot write that this perpendicular is 5 and this hypotenuse is 13. It can also be that this perpendicular is 10 and this hypotenuse is 26. So I always use this factor of k whenever I define ratios. This is what we discussed in the ratios lecture also. So if sine theta is 5 by 13, I can write that perpendicular is equal to 5k and the hypotenuse is equal to 13k. This k can be any number. So now I know this is 5k and this is 13k by the Pythagoras theorem, which says hypotenuse square is equal to perpendicular square plus base square. I have hypotenuse is equal to 13k square. I have perpendicular, which is equal to 5k square. And I have to find out the base. So I write it as x square. So I have 169k square is equal to 25k square plus x square. So this gives me 144k square is equal to x square. So x, in other words, if I take the square root, is 12k. So this is mentioned here. So now I know that perpendicular is 5k, the base is 12k, and the hypotenuse is 13k. Once all the three sides of the triangle are known, I can easily write down the rest of the five ratios. So these are the rest of the five ratios. Cos theta is 12 by 13, as it is defined as base by hypotenuse. Tan theta is 5 by 12, as it is defined as perpendicular by the base. Cot theta is just inverse of this, the tan theta. Secant theta is just the inverse of cos theta, so I have just taken the reciprocal here. And cosecant theta is just the inverse of sine theta, which is mentioned in the question. So it is 13 by 5. So now let's move in the second topic on trigonometry, which is trigonometric identities. These are the three identities which you need to remember, and they become really handy when solving questions. What you need to do is you remember this one identity. Sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Now, if you divide this first equation by sin square theta, let's find out what happens. I'll have sin square theta divided by sin square theta plus cos square theta divided by sin square theta is equal to 1 divided by sin square theta. So when we solve this, this cancels out. So I have 1. Cos by sin is cot. So I have 1 plus cot square theta. And reciprocal of sin is cosecant square. So sin square is cosecant square. So I have 1 plus cot square theta is equal to cosecant square theta. So this is the identity I have here. So if you just remember this, you can easily remember this by dividing this by sin square theta. For this identity, you divide this first equation by cos square theta. So divide it by cos square theta. So now you'll have sin square theta by cos square theta plus cos square theta divided by cos square theta is equal to 1 divided by cos square theta. So here sine by cos is tan, so sine square by cos square is tan square theta plus 1. This will give you 1 by cos is secant, so 1 by cos square is secant square. So this gives me secant square theta. So tan square theta plus 1 is secant square theta. So all you need to do is remember this one equation, and then you can easily find out the rest of the trigonometric identities. Now you should know some of the specific angles of trigonometric functions: 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree and 90 degree. You can form this entire table within 2 minutes. I'll just tell you a small trick to do this. So we'll start with sine theta. What you'll do is sine 0 is 0, sine 30 is half, sine 45 is 1 by root 2, sine 60 is root 3 by 2 and sine 90 is 1. How do you memorize? Just divide 0 by 4 and take an under root. For this second value, take 1 by 4 and the under root. Here I have 2 by 4 under the root, 3 by 4 under the root and 4 by 4 under the root. So this comes out to be 0 by 4 is 0, so I get this value 0. 1 by 4 under the root would give me 1 by 2. 2 by 4, it means half under the root. So this gives me 1 divided by root 2. This gives me root 3 by 2 and this gives me 1. This is just a memory tool and there is no logic behind this. Now, once you've written this first line for sine theta using this memory tool of 0 by 4 under the root, 1 by 4 under the root, 2 by 4 under the root and so on, you can easily write all the other 5 identities. I'll tell you how. For cos theta, start from the behind. So you start from 1, you write 1 here, root 3 by 2, you write root 3 by 2 here. Then you write 1 by root 2, 1 by 2 and 0. So you exactly move in the opposite direction. Now how do you write tan theta? As we've discussed before, tan theta is nothing but sine theta divided by cos theta. So what you'll do is 0 divided by 1 gives you 0. 1 by 2 divided by root 3 by 2 gives you 1 by root 3. 1 by root 2 divided by 1 by root 2 gives you 1. Root 3 by 2 divided by 1 by 2 gives you root 3. And 1 divided by 0 is not defined, or we take it as infinity. Now cosecant theta, this is very easy. This is nothing but the reciprocal of sine. So you just take 1 divided by 0, again this is not defined. 1 divided by half, this gives you 2. 1 divided by 1 by root 2, this gives you root 2. So basically just the reciprocal for the sine value here. For secant theta, we know that secant is the reciprocal of cos. So just take the reciprocal for all these values and you'll find secant theta. And similarly, cot theta can be remembered as cos theta by sine theta. So within no time you can form the entire table just by knowing what is this value of sine theta. We'll move to the next concept, which is angle measure. Degree measure, one complete revolution is of 360 degrees. So if I start from this point and take this entire angle till this point, so this angle covered, the entire angle is 360 degrees. 1 degree has 60 minutes, and this is the symbol for minutes, and 1 minute has 60 seconds, and this is the symbol for seconds. Second is the radian measure. 1 complete revolution is defined as 2 pi. So this is equal to 360 in terms of radians. So degree measure, 1 complete revolution is 360 degrees, and in radian measure, 1 complete revolution is 2 pi radians. So I have 2 pi radians is equal to 360, or pi is equal to 180 degrees. So this is what you need to remember. And what is the value of pi? Pi is given as 22 by 7. Let's move to trigonometric functions now. Now what you need to remember is that all the different trigonometric ratios, for example sine theta, cos theta, tan theta, etc., have positive or negative values in different quadrants. So here in this slide we'll discuss the sine of different trigonometric ratios in different quadrants. There's a mnemonic to this. You write after school to cinema. So after school you go to a cinema. Now How do you memorize this? Take the first letter. I have A here. So all trigonometric ratios are positive in the first quadrant. So this quadrant is from 0 degrees till 90 degrees. So from 0 till 90, all the trigonometric ratios will be positive. For example, I take sine 47 degrees or any other ratio. For example, cosecant 32 degrees. All these ratios, if the angle this 47, 32 lies between 0 degree and 90 degree or in the first quadrant, then their values are positive. Let's move on to the second quadrant. So after school, I take the initial letter first again, which is S. So this means that in the second quadrant, sine and the reciprocal of sine, which is cosecant, are positive. So I have sine plus its reciprocal, which are positive. So if I tell you I have to find out sine 120 degrees, not the value, just only the sine, so it would be a positive value because the second quadrant is from 90 till 180 degrees. So in sine 120 lies in the second quadrant and sine is positive in the second quadrant, so sine 120 degrees is positive. Similarly, if I write tan 103 degrees, I know that tan is negative in this quadrant. Only sine and cosecant are positive. So tan 103 would definitely be a negative value. Similarly, let's say cos 93 degrees, this will also be a negative value since 93 is in the second quadrant and only sine and cosecant are positive in the second quadrant. Rest all the ratios are negative. Let's move on to the third quadrant. So after school, 2 cinema. So I have a T here. So tan and cot are positive in this third quadrant. The third quadrant is from 180 degrees till 270 degrees. So if I have an angle like tan 192 degrees, so this is a positive quantity since 192 lies in the third quadrant and tan is positive in the third quadrant, so I can easily say that this tan 92 is a positive quantity. Similarly, if I have a cot and some angle, let's say 250 degrees, this is also a positive quantity. But rest all of the ratios, for example, sine 210 or let's say cos 190, all these will be negative since only tan and cot are positive. Similarly, let's move on to this last quadrant after school to cinema. This C is for cos and secant. As we discussed in the previous quadrants, if I have something like cos 300 degrees, this would be a positive quantity. Whereas if I have a sine 300 degrees or a cosecant 300 degrees, anything other than cos and secant basically, so this would be definitely be a negative quantity. I hope you are clear with the signs in the different quadrants. We move to trigonometric functions. Now here, what is important is that sine 2n pi plus theta is sine theta. Now if you look here carefully, 2n pi is nothing but 1, you add 360 each time. If you put n is equal to 0, you will have sine theta. If you put n is equal to 1, you will have sine 2 pi plus theta. So if I put n is equal to 1, you have sine 2 pi plus theta. If you put n is equal to 2, you have sine 4 pi plus theta. If you put n is equal to 3, so you have sine 6 pi plus theta. Basically, what I'm trying to explain here is that you complete one revolution here. For 2 pi, you complete one revolution. For 4 pi, you complete two revolutions because one revolution is for 2 pi. And for 6 pi, you complete three complete revolutions. And then you add this theta. So this theta is basically this angle. And since all the angles are positive in the first quadrant, as we already discussed, so all these values will be positive. And whenever you have 2n pi plus theta, these numbers, sine will remain sine. The trigonometric ratios do not change themselves. cos 2n pi plus theta will be cos theta, tan 2n pi theta will be tan theta, cosecant 2n pi plus theta will be cosecant theta, and similarly for the rest of the trigonometric ratios. So these are something which you need to remember, that if you have 2n pi plus theta and any trigonometric ratios, you can simply write this angle as theta. If I have to take an example, let's say I have to find out sine 390 degrees, let's say. So you can write this as sine 360 plus 30 degrees. Now this 360 is 2 pi, which is nothing but this first equation which I have written here by replacing n with 1. So I can easily write this as sine 2n pi plus 30 degrees. This gives me sine 30 degrees, and as I know, sine 30 degrees is half, which we've already discussed. So the value of sine 390 will also be half. So this is where these trigonometric ratios or trigonometric functions become handy. We'll discuss a few more. Now let's take some other angles, for example sine 90 minus theta. These are trigonometric ratios for complementary angles. Now you need to remember, whenever you have a 90 degree here or a 270, it can also be a 270, 90 degree or 270, then sine will change to cos. So we have pairs, sine changes to cos, and vice versa, cos will change to sine, tan changes to cot, and vice versa, and similarly cosecant changes to secant, and vice versa. This is only when you have 90 degrees. So here I have sine 90 minus theta. So the first thing I will take care of is that sine changes to cos. Now will it be a positive or a negative quantity? As I've already discussed when we discussed sines of this angle, sine 90 minus theta, I have the first quadrant from 0 to 90, will be somewhere here in the first quadrant. Sine 90 minus theta would be somewhere here, because I have 90 minus theta, so it comes back in the first quadrant. And in the first quadrant, all the angles, all the trigonometric ratios are positive, therefore I have a plus cos theta. Similarly, cos 90 minus theta will give me sine theta. Cos changes to sine because I have a 90 here, and it is a positive sine theta because 90 minus theta is an angle in the first quadrant. And for angles in the first quadrant, all the trigonometric ratios are positive quantities. Similarly, tan 90 minus theta, tan changes to cot, cosecant changes to secant, and all with positive signs. Why? Because again, you need to remember that in the first quadrant, all the trigonometric ratios are positive. Now let's take a twist here. Let's say I have sine 90 plus theta. Now what is this equal to? First thing you need to note here is, since it's a 90 here, you'll convert sine to cos. Now you need to look at 90 plus theta. Where does 90 plus theta lie? 90 plus theta would lie somewhere in the second quadrant. So this would be theta. Theta is always taken as an acute angle in these cases. It is mentioned in the question. So sine 90 plus theta, this 90 plus theta is somewhere in the second quadrant. And I know that sine is positive in the second quadrant, so I'll have a plus cos theta here. Similarly, let's say if I have something like sine 270 plus theta, again, because it's 270, I will change sine to cos, because sine is paired up with cos. So I'll simply write first cos theta here, and now I'll have to check up the sine. So 270 plus theta, I have this axis as 180 degrees, and I have 270 here. So 270 degrees plus theta would be somewhere here in the fourth quadrant. I know that in the fourth quadrant only cos and secant are positive. So sine 270 plus theta, this means sine of an angle in the fourth quadrant, this is negative, so I'll have a minus cos theta here. Similarly, if I take another example, let's take a last example. I have, let's say, cot 180 plus theta. Now, since there is 180 here and not 90 or 270, so cot will be retained as cot. So I'll have cot theta here. The only thing I need to take care of now is whether it will be with a positive sign or a negative sign. So cot 180 plus theta is somewhere here in this third quadrant, and I know that in this third quadrant tan and cot are positive. So cot 180 plus theta would be a positive quantity, so I'll label it as plus cot theta. So the takeaways from this slide: if you have a 90 or a 270, then you will change the trigonometric ratio to its respective pair. So I had 90 here and I had 270 here, so I changed sine to cos, and here I changed sine to cos again because it was 90. And then you will look up whether the sine will be a positive one or a negative one. But in case you have a 180 degrees or a 360 degrees, so then what you'll do is you'll retain this ratio, cot will remain cot, and then you will check up for the sine. So let's move on to trigonometric ratios for supplementary angles. Now this you can answer easily, as we've already discussed. So sine 180 minus theta, since it's a 180, sine will be retained as sine. And 180 minus theta is an angle in the second quadrant where sine is positive, so I have a plus sine theta. Similarly, cos 180 minus theta. Now 180 minus theta is an angle in the second quadrant and cos is negative in the second quadrant. So this will be equal to minus cos theta and not plus cos theta. So take care, it's a minus cos theta. Tan 180 minus theta again will be minus tan theta, not tan theta. Cosecant 180 minus theta, cosecant is the reciprocal of sine, which is positive in the second quadrant. So 180 degrees means cosecant is retained at cosecant, and since it is positive in the second quadrant, so I have a plus cosecant theta. Secant 180 minus theta, since cos is negative in the second quadrant, so secant 180 minus theta will be a negative secant theta. Similarly, cot 180 minus theta will also be a negative cot theta. So you need to take care of the signs. I had just written that these trigonometric ratios will be retained, and the signs I have discussed now. So this will be a plus, minus, minus, plus, minus, and then again minus. Let's look at the graphical representation. This comes handy because sometimes in examinations they give you a graph and then they ask you what trigonometric function graph is it. So you can just remember these graphs. I'll tell you a simpler way to remember. If this is 0, I know that sine 0 is 0 and sine 90 is 1. So I have a 0 here. At 0, the value of y, this is the value of y, is 0. So it is at the origin. Sine 90, as we move x towards pi by 2 or 90, this value becomes 1. Again, sine 180 is 0, so it becomes 0 again. Then it will move in the negative side because it crosses the second quadrant. So this is nothing but sine 270 degrees. And sine 270 degrees is minus 1. And similarly, for 360 degrees, it again becomes 0. So this becomes a cycle. And then this wave will keep on reproducing itself in either directions. So now we know that for sine theta, I have this kind of a wave. And this wave keeps on repeating itself. So after every 2 pi angles covered, the values of sine theta will repeat themselves. Let's look at the value graph for cos theta. I know that cos 0 is 1, so that is why for 0 I have a 1 here. Cos pi by 2 is 0, so that is why at pi by 2 I have a 0 value here. Cos 270 degrees is again 0, and cos 180 degrees is minus 1. So cos 180 degrees here, this is minus 1, and then I have cos 270 degrees as 0 and then cos 2 pi as 1. So I have this wave, and this again keeps on repeating itself. So the value of cos theta also repeats itself after a cycle of 2 pi. Let's look at the graph for tan theta. This is generally asked in examinations. So tan 0 is 0, as I know, because tan 0 would be what? Sine 0 divided by cos 0. This is equal to tan 0, and sine 0 is 0, cos 0 is 1, so it is 0 by 1, which is again 0. So that is why I, for 0 degrees, I have this point of origin here. For pi by 2, I will have sine pi by 2 divided by cos pi by 2 is equal to tan pi by 2. Since cos pi by 2 is 0 and sine pi by 2 is 1, so this gives me 1 by 0, which is again not defined or infinity. That is why at pi by 2, this goes to positive infinity. Similarly, for minus pi by 2, it will go to minus infinity. So that is why this is a graph for tan theta. And tan theta repeats itself after an interval of pi. So cot theta, again, you can make the graph as I've discussed before. Find out the value of cot 0, cot pi by 2 and cot pi, and you'll be able to form this graph. Again, if you see, this graph is same as this graph is same as this graph. So it means that from 0 to pi, whatever happens in cos, in cot, also happens in pi to 2 pi. So the period for cot theta is pi. Or in other words, cot theta repeats its values after a period of pi. Cosecant theta, again, you can just put in values and then look at how this graph is being formed. And similarly for secant theta, what you can do is you can pause this video for a second, try out different values for secant theta and cosecant theta, which we discussed in the table where I discussed values of these trigonometric ratios, and then you'll be through with these graphs. You don't need to remember them, but in the examination, just put values at different angles: 0 degree, 90 degrees, 360 degrees, 270 degrees, some 3-4 values, and whichever graph is matching, you can simply